y'all. It's Natalie today for A Cherry on Top, and I am creating a New Year's Eve layout. Happy New Year's Eve. And so I am going to use this photo from last year of me and my husband and this cute little stamp set from Concord and Knights that's called Happy Balloon Stamp Set. So I grabbed this black and gold paper from Echo Park, and it is from a wedding collection. But it just like has confetti, and so it definitely has a New Year's Eve vibe. So first I'm gonna start the stamping. So grab some white cardstock, and you'll see me use a few different colors here. I grabbed all the blacks and the grays from my collection, but this first gray that I end up using is a little too brown. It's almost like a grayish color, and so I actually don't end up using those balloons. But it's okay, like I tested out the stamps to see them. So I grabbed that one, darker gray right there is Hickory Smoke. It's a distress oxide. So that's why you see me using my heat gun to dry it, because in between stamping layers, you do need to dry it off. And this is when the stamping platform comes in super great, because I want multiple layers of color on there. And then I decide I need another color thrown in, so I use Meant to Be from Catherine Pooler. And it's a dye ink, and so they are fabulous and crisp and dry really quickly. So now I'm going to go on top with the embellishment balloons, I guess you can call them, just the ones that have designs on them. And I'm going to do some embossing. So I do embossing in white, in black, and in my favorite glitter gold from Wow Embossing. That black is from Nuvo. It's super great. The white, I'm not sure what brand that is, but Wow Embossing is definitely my favorite. But Nuvo embossing powder is also great, but that's what that glitter is, and it's so beautiful, and I love to use it to get glitter on my page, but then it's not loose glitter and it's not making mess. So there I fussy cut all of the balloons that I stamped and embossed, and then I go back and decide I want to use the little banner as well as a couple of the little tassels from the stamp set. So, and I'm gonna fussy cut them all. They didn't have a corresponding die, so that's okay though, because I was like, I'm not very good at fussy cutting, but I can cut some balloons, right? I love this set because of course you think it's like for happy birthday, but then I will use it for this page's New Year's Eve. I definitely would use it for like a Disney World page. So when I put everything on the page how I wanted it, it was just too much empty space. So I decided to make it a 9x12 layout, because I didn't have a lot of journaling to add or anything. So 9x12 was sufficiently large enough to show what I wanted to show. So now I'm going to layer up my balloons. And what I do is I stick a lot of them down to the paper, but then some of them I pop up on some foam tape. So that way we get different dimensions, and I can layer them and they look really nice, and then I can tuck the photo up under them. I just really like the different dimensions that and texture that it gives doing that. So I'm gonna add some string for the balloons. And so I grab this like baker's twine, it's white and it has gold sparkle in it. And so what I do is I use my Nuvo glue, and I stick down the twine at the end, and then I kind of just twist it the way I want it to look, and then I kind of just run the glue along the edge and it will hold it in place. I add a few curly cues in there and stuff. So sorry I left this big empty section in. I think I was unclogging my Nuvo glue. It's getting low and the top doesn't fit on super great because there's a lot of glue stuck up at the top, and so sometimes it will dry out. I love my Nuvo glue. It holds really well. So I would just suggest cleaning out the top, and that won't happen. But I'm obviously a super messy crafter. So there's where I'm going with it. So I'm just making sure that's how I want my strings. And I go through and I add a bunch of strings and cut them at different lengths. And so I'm gonna combine them all at the bottom there with a bow in a little bit. While we have a lull, I will say I have posted my affiliate link down below. Check it out if you want to grab anything from the store. We have all kinds of new goodies all the time. They're constantly adding new things. Like literally every week there's something new in the store. So you can use my affiliate link and I would really appreciate it. Let me know if you have any questions, because I love comments on my stuff and I will definitely get back to you. So that's going to be kind of like my title. So I add the happy balloon. I did move it down a little bit. And then I put 2020 on the banner. Who knew, right? But I'm going in with the mindset that we didn't know what a disaster it was going to be. So I just cut those out with the Heather lowercase alpha set from Pinkfresh Studio and some glitter paper. And then I add my tassels, and then I add my glitter bow, and that's it. I did find another gold tassel off screen, or I actually made another one because I lost it. So I added that up there. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great New Year's. I hope 2021 brings all the good things to you. And I appreciate you watching. Let me know if you have any questions. Bye, y'all.